Thank you very much, Mr. Esprit, Shanks Esprit, for this warm welcome, and thank you for your really warm and generous welcome. Let me join the others before me in recognizing the members at the head table, the Honorable Minister for Housing, Water Resource Management, Land, and plenty other things. Honorable Reginald Ostrey, Honorable Lady Catherine Daniel, Minister for Social Services and Community Development and Gender Affairs. Also the Minister for Agriculture and Fisheries, Honorable Johnson Drygo. I notice a full cadre of other ministers present in the audience. Honorable Peter Saint-Jean, my neighboring Member of Parliament, my cousin, Honorable Kelvin Joseph. First and Joseph. And former Member of Parliament for the Collyhill constituency, Ronald Tuller. And of course, your very own caretaker, Nicole Shanks Esprit. Let me also recognize, she put herself in a corner, so I almost forgot her, Honorable Rosalind Paul, Minister for Commerce and Small Business. Let me also recognize a few Ardent Labour Party supporters in the audience from the neighboring constituency of St. Joseph, Mr. John Charles and Teacher Vina, welcome. And of course, you, the wonderful people of Mount Prosper. Rachette. I have been informed that you have a population of approximately 500, and I see about 400 people here today, this evening. So that means that more than 3/4 of the population of Mount Prosper is here to lend solidarity. I'm gonna write it so I wouldn't forget. Morne Rachette is here. And this means that more than 3/4 of the population is here. And it's certainly much more than they had at the meeting at Salisbury a few weeks ago, I know for sure. And maybe much more than the handful of people that they had on February 7, for sure. What it also tells is that the people of Morne Rachette, are in strong solidarity with the present Labour Party administration. And it also speaks to the leadership, of course, and mobilization of your caretaker, Mr. Nicole Shanks Esprit. And of course, listening to the comprehensive report that he gave, it leads you to wonder, but what are they talking about when they say that the Salisbury constituency is being left out? Because just one road, just one feeder road alone is costing the government $10 million. Just one road within the constituency. And I'm pretty sure if I ask any of the other members of parliament here today, this is much more than we've spent in any one of the constituencies, and even the constituencies which voted the Dominica Labour Party. One road of yours, $10 million. So that already is much more than any one of us would have spent in our constituency since the last general election. And that's important. That's important. Because when your member of parliament comes to you and tries to make you believe that nothing is being done in the Salisbury constituency, you have to quote figures. And this is what they are afraid of, the United Workers' Party. They like to talk off their head and just rule rhetoric and every trick. You have to quote figures to them. And in case you need the figures, I think I was about to say the Honorable Shanks Esprit would have the figures so he can total them for you, so you can tell him, here it is. Here's the amount of money that the Labour Party government is spending in the Salisbury constituency. So it's my pleasure to be here. I've known Mr. Esprit, Nick, I can call him Shanks, for a very long time. And when he asked me to speak tonight, I had no choice. I had no choice but to show up. Always been a very hectic past 7 days for us. A number of constituencies and villages visited, and a number of town hall meetings. But when he said that, when he asked me to be present tonight, I had no choice, as I said, to lend my solidarity. And of course, as you know, this town hall meetings is an initiative of the DLP administration, where we've been going around the country educating people, sharing the information with you. And as small a village as Morne Rachette is, as Morne Rachette is, we felt that no community is going to be left out while we do a town hall meeting, which is where we're here tonight to share some information with you. And I really want to join Honorable Drygo in congratulating your caretaker, Mr. Nicole Shanks Esprit, for his hard work. And the Dominican Labour Party administration thanks Mr. Esprit for his enthusiasm and for his efforts to date in representing the people as the de facto Member of Parliament. Because your Member of Parliament doesn't know anything about representing you except to walk up and down and to look, find out where the next jam is, and now and then come and talk nonsense on the radio. And although a lot has been said before, and by the speakers before me, and of course speaking lower down the line always makes it easier because a lot would have been said that I would have liked to see. But I still think it would be remiss of me if I don't spend a few minutes to share some of the information with you, the work being done, especially within the Ministry of Health and Environment, which I have the honor to lead. Yes, sir. And to let you know as to the progress, as I said, of projects within the Ministry of Health and the Environment. And of course, we can begin with our flagship project, the new National Hospital. A gift, and I want to repeat this, a $40 million US dollar gift. This is converted into $108 million EC dollars gift from the People's Republic of China. And it's very important to note these things, and I'll tell you why as we go down the line. And of course, a lot of this would be a result of the friendships forged by this current administration, especially by our leader, Honorable Roosevelt Skerritt. And I remember when Roosevelt Skerritt came into, took on the mantle as leadership of the party and the government some years ago, and he made these very bold moves, these really groundbreaking moves towards forging relationships with countries like China and non-traditional countries. A lot was said, and we heard them on the other radio station trying to scare people. Oh, we are moving towards communism, and soon our young sons and daughters will be shipped to China to join the army. A lot of nonsense. Okay, but right now we can see the results of forging relationships with the PRC, People's Republic of China, the results that this is bringing to our country. And we can start to projects before the new National Hospital. We can speak to the stadium where we can now see first class and international matches for the very first time in Dominica. The Dominica State College and the Rural Enhancement Project or Rehabilitation Project, the State House, all of these, the West Coast Road, rehabilitation of the West Coast Road, all of these are major projects funded by the People's Republic of China from grant funding, meaning that money we don't have to pay back one black cent. So now that the hospital has started, and of course you heard a lot about this hospital, the opposition spent the better part of the last 2-3 years saying that the hospital was just a political and election ploy, just a gimmick. And those of you who would have had the pleasure to follow us around during the election campaign would have seen the wonderful launching and animation at St. Joseph, and the neighboring St. Joseph, where we showed you what your new national hospital is going to look like. And yes, we were a little bit slow in getting off the ground. And I can tell you that it's because your government and the Ministry of Health, and of course yes, truly as a minister, wanted to ensure that we got the best option available. Because we have to understand that, yes, we were given designs and plans for the new hospital, but we had to ensure that whatever we're getting is something that was going to be useful to us, and also something that our donors, the People's Republic of China, something that they were going to be proud of as the donors to our country. So we are a bit slow in getting started, but we started anyway, and I want to report to you that the progress on the hospital is going along extremely well. And a number of the concerns that we had as it pertains to building a hospital on the existing site, as it pertains to noise and pollution, a lot of these concerns have been kept to a minimum. And I want to continue to say that God is a good God and God has blessed this Dominican Labour Party administration. Because a lot of things that they wish for, and I mean, sometimes it bamboozles me sometimes, you know, to think of people who say they love Dominica, or even Dominicans. You don't even have to love Dominica, but just being a Dominican, to wish for something bad to happen to a good thing that is going to happen to you. Because at the end of the day, this hospital is not only going to serve people who support the Labour Party administration, it's going to serve each and every Dominican. So really, sometimes, you know, I shake my head, you know, when I hear some people, you know, basically wishing that the project, something goes bad with the project, you know, and you're going to get a $40 million US dollar project. I mean, how can you wish bad for it? And these are coming from people who have hopes of being in the leadership in government. But God is a good God, and I'm telling you that God is a good God, and no time, nowhere in the foreseeable future is he going to allow them to enter the corridors of power in Dominica, because they do not mean well for the country. So this new hospital is going to be built in phases, because as I said, the challenge is of building a new hospital on an existing site. And of course, I've explained countless times before why we chose the new site, because we were advised by the experts that the new site would be the most suitable for the new national hospital. I don't want to go through it again. So we're going for 7 phases. The first phase is being built, which is the construction of 2 major buildings, what we like to refer to as a casualty, or in medical terms, the accident and emergency department, and the second building to house radiology, stuff like x-rays, your new MRI, CT scan, and the laboratory. So by August, September this year, you should have the commissioning of your brand new A&E department and the second medical and what they call technology building. Ready for use, that is. Not just built, but ready and commissioned for use, immediate use. Because we have to understand, because building on the existing site means that we have to ensure that whatever we build is ready for use before breaking down the temporary structure and moving to a next phase. And the Chinese would have told us, and as I said, in retrospect, while we would have had our doubts as to building on the new site, on an existing site, sorry, in retrospect, that is going to be a blessing in disguise. Because what it means is that by the end of the 7 phases, we are guaranteed to have a functioning, working hospital. And if we know the Chinese well, they told us that they need 30 months, 2.5 years to build this hospital. But if we know them well, we know that by the end of the 29 months and 29 days, that this hospital will be ready and fully commissioned. So not only are we going to have a brand new building, state-of-the-art building, part of the project includes some exciting new and modern state-of-the-art equipment, like an MRI. A lot of you would know what an MRI is, what they call a magnetic resonance imaging, which is what a lot of us have to travel to Antigua, Guadeloupe, Martinique, for many a times. This comes with the project, and also a cancer treating IC teacher, Vida. I'm sure she'll be happy to hear that, what they call an ultra-frequency sonogram to treat cancer patients right here in Dominica. Now, these will be new equipment that comes with the project. But in addition, we would have gotten a commitment from the government that they are willing to procure any other equipment that befits a new modern hospital. So by the time your hospital is complete in 30 months, you're going to have not only a beautiful new building with new beds, etc., but also brand new state-of-the-art equipment that befits a new modern hospital. And not only this, a new building, new equipment, but also new services. And as we speak, we have a number of doctors specializing around the world in exciting new services that never before were available here in Dominica, that you would have had to travel to Guadeloupe or Martinique for, such as geriatric, that's to do with senior citizens, nephrology, the kidneys, emergency medicine, intensive care, among many others. We also have an oncologist specializing, Teacher Vina, just to bring another smile to your face. I saw you clapping about the equipment, so to bring another smile to your face. So we have, as we speak, another dozen or so Dominicans, we're talking about born and bred Dominicans, specializing in these various sub-disciplines. So by the time the hospital is commissioned, these people would be back, ready to serve the country in these exciting new services. But we have to ask ourselves that all of this is good, new hospital, new equipment, plenty new doctors, new services. But these services have to be affordable and accessible to the everyday Dominican. And we know that we have to find money, first of all, to pay these doctors, these specialists, and these days they're asking for more and more money. And if we need to retain them here in Dominica, we have to meet them somewhere. We also have to pay to maintain, service, and repair this equipment, and also to replace them when they go bad. All the new things that sometimes people come to doctors to ask for, they cost money. How are we going to pay for this? And of course, here comes the issue of national health insurance, or what we like to refer to as universal health coverage. And it's an issue that many governments all over the world, even developed countries, would have been battling with. I always refer to Obama and Obamacare. Look at all the difficulty that Obama had in getting Obamacare started in the US. And right now, of course, we know what Trump wants to do with it. Okay, so the issue of universal health coverage, meaning health services available to all and sundry, is very expensive. which is why your government, although much has been said before about national health insurance, your government, this Labour Party administration, has taken the bold move to invest $5 million into what they call a pilot national health insurance program. So it had to take us to make the bold move because we felt that we had spoken enough and talked and everybody trying to come up with the right formula. So what we've decided is let us target a group of individuals. And in this case, we're talking about mothers below the age of 35 with children below the age of 3. So the idea is that as we go along and depend on the success or how manageable or sustainable this target program is, we continue incrementally adding people to this program and other target groups until such time that each and every Dominican is covered under this policy. So the National Health Insurance is well underway, and come April 3rd, I think, that we are going to have the launching of this National Health Insurance program. Not only, and speaking of work being done in constituencies that would not have voted the Dominican Labour Party, just a couple of days ago, we heard that the government of Mexico committed $5 million into the construction of the Marigot Hospital. Yes, the Marigot Hospital. $5 million, again converted into $13 million. Having been committed by the government of Mexico into the construction of the new Marigot Hospital. But even before that, people, we would have heard those of us who follow parliament and those of us who take interest in budget debates and estimates, etc., would know that we would have had $1.5 million budgeted towards improving the health services in the Marigot Health District, $300,000 towards the designs of the new Marigot Hospital, and another $1.2 million towards the improvement of the primary healthcare services in the Marigot Health District. So while, yes, I can say that we were a little slow in getting things going in Marigot, and I can cite a number of reasons why, not giving excuses, but bona fide reasons why, the new National Hospital occupied a lot of our time, plus also the technical support that we require sometimes to get some of these projects rolling is not always forthcoming in a timely manner from the Ministry of Public Works, which is why your government, recognizing the limitations within the Ministry of Public Works, would have put in place within the Ministry of Health a whole technical team, what they call a project management unit, to manage these capital projects within the Ministry of Health. So we should see work starting to roll much faster in the coming months. So we are going to invest, as I said, $13 million in the new Marigot Hospital. And in the meantime, of course, we have $1.5 million to go towards the design of this hospital and $1.2 to improve the primary healthcare services within the Marigot Health District. So all the foaming at the mouth and the ranting and raving of the opposition leader, member of parliament for Marigot, he knows what is going on, that we are going to move ahead with the Marigot Health District. And I want to tell you why this is important. I mentioned the issue of the monies from China and also the government of Mexico, because you would have heard them saying that this is a rogue government and how all countries and institutions in the world are snubbing us because we are corrupt and all sorts of fraudulent acts. But here we have, just 2 days ago, a foreign government pledging $13 million towards the construction of the Marigot Hospital. So that by itself goes a long way in refuting what you hear them saying out there, to give the impression that we are a rogue government, we are a rebel government, and all institutions. And I can talk to a number of other projects. Nicole's Esprit mentioned the construction of a 60,000 imperial gallon water tank here in Morne Rachette. And this is coming from a $38 million project from the World Bank being managed by the Ministry of Health and Environment. $38 million from the World Bank. So how is it that you're saying that institutional governments, they don't trust us, when we have foreign governments just invest $13 million, another $40 million project, World Bank project, investing in the government of Dominica? It goes to show that this Labour Party administration continues to demonstrate that we have the transparency and accountability for foreign governments and institutions to still believe in us to execute projects to better the lives of our people. Before I end, I think it would be remiss of me if I don't also lend my thoughts to what is going on in Dominica as we speak. And your caretaker, I was about to say PAL rep, would have spoken as to the wonderful things, your PAL rep, would have spoken to the wonderful things that he would have done for the people of this area and also his plans. And we have to ask ourselves that where is the funding for, where are the resources coming from? And post-tropical storm Erica, we need to understand that Erica left us a debt of $1.4 billion, people. And I like to say every time I speak, billion is not the one with the six zeros, it's the one with the nine zeros. $1.4 billion. What it means is that the government, your government, would now have to seek $1.4 billion just to repair, just to restore the damage that would have been done by Tropical Storm Erica. Now, yet still, we see all of these programs continuing. The Yes We Care, the care of the elderly, all of these roads that we're talking about, the washroom project, and small business assistance being given, just name it. Now, we have to ask ourselves, it would be very easy for us to come back to you after Erica to say, listen, people, all of these nice things that we have been doing, we have to put it on a pause because we now have places to repair, we have people to relocate, etc. But no, we continued with all of these programs. In fact, most, if not all of these programs would have intensified. We would have seen an increase in the number of people under the National Employment Program. We would have seen an intensifying of the community roads being rehabilitated around the island and the building of washrooms, etc. And we have to ask ourselves, thank God for this stream of revenue called the Citizenship by Investment Program, where we could continue to work for the people of this country in spite of Tropical Storm Erica. So we hear them saying that these days everything is CBI, and I tell them we make no apologies for that. Yes, everything is CBI because without this source of funding, as I said, all of these wonderful things that we are doing in Dominica would have stopped. Because God knows that without this source of funding, we would have had to resort to other methods. Because we have to understand that while governments and institutions, they pledge to help us, committed to helping us, and of course they would have reached out to us as much as they can. But a lot of these other countries, they also have their own domestic issues to deal with. So we have to understand that without this CBI, as I said, all of these things would have slowed down or even stopped. But there's a God above, and God knows that we needed another source of revenue to help our people without imposing any taxes on them, which is called the CBI. And we know that a good God, and he will continue to ensure that in spite of the opposition efforts to derail and destroy this program, that this program will continue. And let's not be fooled, people. All of these things you see that they're doing or trying to do, it's nothing to do with they wanting to know what's going on, okay? Because the records are there to show what's going on. The Prime Minister, Minister of Finance budget address is there to show what are the things that we are doing in the CBI. And even in black and white in the budget estimates, you can see which of these programs and projects that are going to be funded by the CBI. What they're interested in doing is destroying our country and losing people's trust in investing in Dominica. This is what they're trying to do. And then listen to them about that issue of the night of February 7th, that it was just some random act of violence and just some a few little vinegar wrong tongue. No, it wasn't. Because prior to darkness falling, we heard them. They're on the record by trying to say that no police or nobody can stop them from doing what they want. So how can you be saying these things and all of a sudden dissociating yourself from what happened later down the evening? So let's not fool ourselves. All of this was a part. All of this was part of a plan to try to destroy the wonderful image of Dominica. And in closing, to let you know that one of the reasons why our CBI program is so successful, because a lot of other countries, even other Caribbean and OECS countries, would be engaging in such a program. And in fact, a lot of them would have started before us and would have been far ahead of us. But one of the reasons our program is so successful is because of what we like to call the socio-political stability of Dominica, meaning that you would have voted the same government for the past 17 years. It means that you, the wonderful people of Morne Rachette, and Dominica would know, you know what you're about and you know what you want. So these are the things that people, So these are the things that people who are looking to invest in the country or even seeking a second citizenship, these are the things that they are looking for in the country. Political stability, low crime rate, etc. So what they're trying to do, and all of these things you see and the burning of Rosso, is trying to create this image out there that Dominica is this very violent place. So please stay away. But as I said, there's a good God above, and we will continue to do well, and the CBI program will continue to prosper. So this CBI is not any illegal or sinister or top secret activity. As I said, a number of countries around the world are involved in this program, even countries that you would not even believe. USA, Canada, UK. Those of you, we say all the time, you can Google it. EB-5 program in America, where if you invest $500,000, they expedite your permanent residence application. And I think you even get back the $500,000 at the end of a certain time, because of course they would have taken it to invest in something else. That's how much you want people to come to the USA to invest. So let's not follow ourselves and to make it appear that myself and Reggie and all of us that we're walking around with passports in our pocket and standing in the corner and selling passports. The police force, the immigration department, all of you know the process, how one gets a passport. As we speak, they're the only one with a machine or authorized to issue any passport. So the applicant will have to go through the process, ask about them, due diligence, they've cleared, and then the citizenship and the passport is issued. So we want to continue to pray that God continues to have mercy on us, and of course to thwart the plans of the opposition. Okay, because as I said, we have to understand that if this CBI program fails as we speak, a number of the things that we are doing, and I can speak to my very own constituency, the resettlement of the Petite Savanne constituency, or Petite Savanne community rather, which is set to cost over $100 million, depends solely on the success of the CBI. And I've warned my people and them that follow in the opposition to talk their BTs or their nonsense when they're ready, that while they're talking their nonsense, they need to understand that if this CBI program fails, that they will have to start to debouiller themselves, as we say in Patois, okay? And all of this help that we give into them, the rent allowance, and even the construction of homes for them for free that they're not going to pay one dime for, that all of this will not come to fruition. So they have to be careful, because as Mr. Esprit said, and he said something that might be very controversial, but I want to support him, that the government owes nobody anything after any natural disaster. But because of the human nature of this administration, we decide to come in to assist. So they need to understand, my people from Petite Savanne and some of you who also will be carded for assistance, that while you try to destroy the CBI, the CBI goes, along with it will go all of these wonderful things that we're doing for the people of this country. So let me just close by saying that I want to thank you for your steadfast support to the Dominican Labour Party administration. I wish that your neighboring villages or your neighboring villages that make up the constituency would follow suit like Morne Rachette and vote the Labour Party overwhelmingly. But we have faith that after we're done with these wonderful programs, that they will see right through their worthless and useless PAL rep. And next time it comes to them for their vote, they'll tell him, PAL rep, get tout sa gouvernement fait bano. I'm talking about Coulibistria and Salisbury. That they can tell him, get sa tout sa chance ever gouvernement fait bano. Okay, nous pas vlez encore, nous qui vote chance next election. And we are waiting with open arms to welcome you, the people of the Salisbury constituency, to the Labour Party family. I thank you very much. Yep.